Learn organization. vote for an operating on the New England code. Abda.
If I have to rip it one more bolt in place today, my teeth are going to fall off.
That's it.
You said it.
Let your teeth fall off. It's awkward, you're cut. Whatever you do, tell someone that it's a small sacrifice.
Yeah, but it's my teeth that are being sacrificed, not yours.
Read all about it. Every submarine sinks 6,000 pounds of Allied shipping.
You don't hear that? What awful news!
Let me have a paper, Hermione.
Let me have 3 cents.
I'm flat broke. Who's got 3 cents?
I got 2.
I never carry pennies.
Well, I'm the only one, Hermione.
Don't you always?
We're good for it. You know we are.
We'll pay that next month.
Pay it.
I should be so lucky here.
More news is terrible. Never seems to get any better.
They're sending that cargo ship to John Paul Jones, one torpedo after another.
The John Paul Jones!
Drink to the bottom. Read all about it on page 2.
We worked on that ship.
No news is good news these days. We could be invaded any moment.
Oh, no! I'm going to replace the clock. I'm going to ask the foreman to give me some overtime.
How come the U-boats always find our ship?
You see, spies are everywhere.
Everywhere covers a lot of territory.
I have spies who love to know we're getting more ships ready to sail.
Why did you say no, boss?
Sorry.
Why won't help you?
I won't forget. Honest.
We don't need to move on. We'll be late at the shipyard. There's a lot of work.
And where the girls will be doing?
Lens Derivator.
Valley Derivator.
Melbourne Derivator.
Red Ribbon.
Don't forget you girls owe me a penny. Extra, extra, extra edition of the Brooklyn Eagle.
from this very room. You'll be able to record a message for home, courtesy of the USO's Star Spangled Network. Professor Milton Sullivan will be here to entertain with his amazing hypnotism act.
He's great. He'll make you think you're a chicken.
A quick introduction to our new hostesses. Let's hear it for Hazel Merrill, Judy Howard, and Lee Jenkins. Courtesy of my devoted assistant, Angie Wilberforce, tonight we've got shredded coconut donuts. Take a bow, Angie. Do, as if fresh baked apple pies and shredded coconut donuts weren't enough, we've got that fabulous tap dancer, the girl who can tap faster than anyone alive. Let's give a big round of applause for Miss Kitty Evans. Hi, fellas.
Hi.
When I do tap, I don't mean lights out. Get ready, get set. A one and a two, and away we go.
Uh-huh.
I have the FBI and the OSS and the USO.
so confusing.
The way of the OSS usually confuses civilians. Listen carefully. Too many ships leaving the Brooklyn Navy Yard never reach the destination. Despite all precautions, enemy U-boats know the location. Orders are sealed until the ships are on their way. Not even the captains know where they're going. The orders arrive via special code. Only a military cryptographer, a code breaker, is authorized to decipher the code. He sails with the ship.
I can't make head nor tail of what you're saying.
We know that three different cryptographers visited the U.S. over the night before they sailed. Each ship they sailed on was repeated. Only one of the three survived and swears he never told anyone what he deciphered.
And somehow, as someone was able to get the information, we believe this U.S. over to be the nerve center for a group of dangerous enemy agents.
What?
Uncle Simon should help us, Taylor.
If what you say is true, what can I do?
Keep your eyes and ears open. Anyone and everyone is subject. We'll be sending log 3 in 1 week. Let them be posted. It's for God.
How will I know that?
We'll tell you they like to sit.
One other thing.
There's only one target who will be enslaved in the court from Mexican. I understand he hanged out
here. His name is Kilroy.
So, Kilroy?
That's it. He's a bit of a jerk, but an absolute genius when it comes to the sergeant.
If you're afraid he's going to pass on information, why don't you restrict him to quarters?
We want Kilroy to circulate. We want to see the tribe's contact. We need to find out how people are getting control of information.
We count on me, gentlemen.
We knew we could. Make sure Kilroy can put no fear out. We don't want to lose him.
Trust me.
There'll be no snafu. I'm working for the OSS now.
I thought you were working for the USO.
You're trying to be funny?
Sorry.
800,000 on the cargo stuff.
The paper says 6,000 tons.
That was just the other day.
If Britain doesn't get her cargo on ship, she doesn't have a chance.
This is a serious game we're playing. A dangerous game. Our backs are up against the wall. Nice talking to you, Taylor. Thanks for your cooperation. I've heard it's all for them around the chart. The missile fleet says, day or night, 24 hours a day, 7 days.
Memorize the number, then destroy the target.
I understand.
Good. That's all clear. Come on, Wolfman. You don't want anyone to see it. This USO club is good for rolling Sterling Jonas and Alpha 5.
Wow. Ruth Taylor, USO club director and volunteer government agent. I know my duty and I'll do it. Kilroy, where are you?
After Astra, read all about it. Tanker fleet off the East Coast continues to be attacked. Situation grave.
Good testimony. You have to tell us the good news?
It's on paper.
Don't get gross. Only a penny.
Watch this edition?
No. We don't have to read bad news. Everybody at the ship now knows what's going on.
It's like I told you before. We can be invaded any second.
You shouldn't talk like that for more.
Why not?
It's bad for morale.
What is great for business? When people are nervous, they find you a team.
Say, how come I never seen you girls dressed up?
Don't you ever go on dates?
With the war on, it's not easy to find one.
Yeah, all the nice guys in uniforms are going overseas.
Last year, they're too young, too old, or friendly.
Well, how about some of those soldier boys stationed at the Navy Yard?
Here today, gone tomorrow. Mm-hmm. I did meet one nice boy. He's drawing a picture of what's meant.
How romantic.
You mean the kid they call Kilroy?
That's right. Joe Kilroy. Private Joe Kilroy.
You must be psychic or something, Gladys.
Well, maybe you say that, Melba.
How do you say?
Private Kilroy? I don't mean the scarecrow from the Wizard of Oz. Hold it. How do I look?
Damn,
it's all right. Thanks for nothing. Yes, I am my newest Angelia. I'm going over to the mall stuff for the Bastille milkshake. Like President Roosevelt says, peace is over.
Hi, Private Kilroy. Remember me? Gladys Brooks. We met when I asked you what you were doing, drawing a picture and what you meant.
Sure, I remember. In class, you didn't tell anyone about what I did. I could get in trouble.
Perish the thought.
Look, Valerie, two more. Aren't they cute?
Here's the
Kilroy.
Tyler, please introduce us to your buddies over there.
My pleasure. You girls have names?
Valerie Fox, Malvin Nesbitt.
Girls meet the boys. Now, Carl Ryder, Private Leo Pickford. Hi, girls.
Pleased to meet you.
Likewise.
I've seen you guys on guard duty over at the Navy Yard.
Temporary, until we get the permanent assignment.
Overseas.
I feel sorry for you guys. You must be so lonely.
Are you kidding? We got the USO.
Our home away from home. Always something happening at the USO. I lift up these posters to announce the radio show we have every week at the club.
Thank you, that's Dr. Kilroy.
My pleasure.
Kilroy likes to draw.
What's this drawing on the back?
That's my special signature. Wherever I go, I doodle that somewhere.
Why, this is the same thing we drew on the left cement.
It's what the medics call compulsion.
Well, some guys bite your nails.
Kilroy doodle.
I figure wherever I go, I'll do my Kilroy sketch and my Kilroy look here. Everyone wonders, hey, who's this guy Kilroy? I'm going to do the same thing.
Me too.
So no matter where our troops go, north, east, south, west, Kilroy will be there. Or the friendly finale is coming.
I figure 1,000 guys will catch on and do the same thing. Kilroy will be everywhere.
You build it first to know.
Oh, Private Kilroy, it's thrilling.
Don't tell anyone else. It'll be our little secret.
Our lips are sealed. All the action's over at
here.
You mean work all day in the shipyard and then work at night all work all night at the USO Club?
It's one way to get a date.
That's different.
Well, what are we waiting for?
Don't say no to the USO.
Louder, please.
Meow, meow.
I believe I was an heir. I know what tree you are. Not puppy. Not chicken. You're a chicken. That's a special one to tell the truth. Walk like chicken. That means you walk like chicken. I want to see you be chicken.
Sorry, Professor. Fooled you. I know you couldn't touch me. I don't like to change into a dog, but a chicken's not a question. That's right. You've got a chicken in your
chest. I'm afraid you boys too strong will. It happens sometimes. Not perfect. Where's the moon from?
Every day we live in, Thank you. Everybody,
Thank you.
Why don't you
say cheese? Doesn't appreciate
me.
Well, you wonderful boys and girls. My
magazine
is donating.
What? Jupa! Jupa!
Right, you're right.
You heard it.
Jupa standing up every night.
Hey, Bob,
relax. What's that Jupa?
Who's to listen? Ah, yeah. There you are, Andy. I knew you would.
We're all in this together.
Yeah.
my voice, Kilroy. Only my voice is not enough. You received a coding message from the sealed order.
Yes.
Have you decoded the message?
Yes.
The message, Kilroy. It tells your brother that you have it. Where is that message? I asked you a question, Kilroy.
Why doesn't he answer?
It's okay. The thing is, Kilroy, listen to my question.
There's the location of the rendezvous.
Oh,
You guys know where you're going?
That's classified information.
What about your buddy? What about Kilroy?
We'll turn out.
What if he doesn't? What if he ships out without saying goodbye?
I'm not a postcard.
You don't mess Kilroy on it.
Kilroy was here. Mm-hmm.
Attention, please. Can I have everyone's attention? Once again, I would like to welcome you all to the Brooklyn USO Club. Are you all having a good time? Yes, I would like to hear it. For those of you who are moving on, don't forget to find the USO Club wherever you are. Your home away from home. We know that at the time,
banana split, jukebox Saturday night, every night.
Hello, moms and dads, brothers and sisters, uncles and aunts, cousins and friends. This is USO Club volunteer Ruth Taylor coming to you from the USO Club on Flatbush Avenue in Brooklyn, New York, USA.
Do we have anyone in the club tonight from Brooklyn?
Yeah!
Anyone from Massachusetts?
Woo!
Anyone from Utah?
Radio friends, we have a wonderful show lined up for you tonight. We have those riveting riveters from down at the Brooklyn Navy Yard, Glanis, Valerie, and Melba. Professor Milton Sullivan is here to entertain with his hypnotism act. We have the fastest cats in show business, the incomparable Miss Kitty Evans. And as usual, a weekly hello from all the G.I. Joes and Jills here at the club.
Come on, kids, crowd around and say hello to all the people on the home front. Down the middle in a big black cat, and I'll take to you, little jukebox club. Oh,
That's only a sample of the fun we're going to have tonight, courtesy of the USO Star Spangled Network. Now for that special treat I know you always enjoy, that mystifying, tantalizing, amazing genius who can look you in the eye and knock you out, the one, the only, the unforgettable Professor Milton Sullivan.
Thank you. What are you doing on top of me, Frank?
Oh, you know I was.
Hi.
Hi.
It's over.
I know.
I think we should do it one more time.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hi, Miss Vanetta.
Hi.
We
gotta get the show on the road.
In the prop box for now.
Ready?
Me and Dennis, right here, number one. With all the play, we'll never happen. No way. Me and Dennis.
I got it all my life.
Oh, yeah, baby. Oh, no.
Oh, yeah. Watch out here. Me and Lance, we're going to raise the roof.
And Dennis, and this one right here, like, skinny, not like Lindsay. True, yeah.
Raise the roof. Woo-hoo. Oh.
I did better than both of them. I'm sorry. You know,
they
suck. It sucks. I'm the best.